Howard Richman, Executive Director of Pennsylvania Homeschoolers Accreditation Agency. This is our 31st annual commencement ceremony. The students who will graduate this evening have met the high standards of our agency, which go far beyond the minimum requirements for high school graduation that are in the Pennsylvania home education law. Normally, a graduation ceremony takes place in a building, but this year, due to COVID, it will take place as a video production. The graduates who are participating in this ceremony share one main thing in common. They all share the ability to overcome technological obstacles in putting together the video clips that you will see. We have an excellent program tonight. We will begin with a commencement speech by world-renowned biologist Dr. Michael Behe, who is also a homeschooling parent in our program. Then you will be able to meet some of these graduates as they give graduation speeches and performances. Then we will have a special greeting from State Representative Jesse Topper, who was one of our graduates in the class of 2000. And finally, families will award their diplomas to their graduates.
Please bow your heads and join me in prayer. Dear Lord, as we gather today, we want to take the time to thank you and give you praise. Although we can't be together in person, we are united in spirit, and we are all so proud to be honoring our graduates. Lord, we want to thank you for the wonderful privilege you've granted us, the ability to homeschool our children. We want to thank you that each family here was able to follow their own unique journey, and that each young adult graduating today was able to pursue his or her own passions and talents. Lord, we want to give you all the praise and all the glory for blessing them with those talents. And Lord, we also want to recognize that tonight is not an end, but rather a beginning. And we want to ask you to watch over these graduates as they move into the next chapter in their lives. Please bless them in their endeavors, keep them safe, and help them honor you. We love you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Now we have a special greeting for these graduates, State Representative Jesse Topper, PHAA graduate from the class of 2000, recorded the following message.
Hi, I'm State Representative Jesse Topper. Congratulations to all the graduates of the Pennsylvania Homeschool Accreditation Agency. This is a very important milestone you have reached and one of the first of many you will achieve. A few short years ago, okay, maybe almost two decades or so ago, I was in your shoes, graduating from a home education program at a time when not many people even knew what homeschooling was or how it worked. And I received a lot of strange looks when I mentioned that I was a homeschooled graduate, and it was always an interesting conversation starter. This past year has been a year like no other. Many of us have never experienced the challenges that faced us over this past year. My earnest hope is that you will take what you have learned in your educational career thus far and apply every bit of knowledge that you have gleaned to navigate these uncertain times. We're counting on you to be servant leaders in your families and communities and this nation moving forward. I wish you nothing but the best as you move on to the next chapter of your life. Once again, congratulations and welcome to the Club of Home Education Graduates. I assure you, we are not as socially awkward as everyone thinks we are. Good luck.
Good evening, and special congratulations to all our graduates in 2021. I'm Susan Richman. I'm a member of the PHAA Board of Directors, It's my pleasure now to introduce our commencement address speaker, Professor Michael Behe, who's a professor of biochemistry at Lehigh University. He and his wife Celeste have 9 children who've all been homeschooled, and 8 of them have received the PHAA diploma, including their younger son, Gerard, who's graduating with us tonight in this virtual ceremony. Professor Behe holds degrees in chemistry and biochemistry and has done postdoc work at the NIH on DNA structure. We're so grateful for your many years of support for PHAA, Professor Behe, and thank you so much for sharing your insights with us tonight.
Greetings to all 2021 Pennsylvania homeschoolers graduates. I'm honored and delighted to address you today in this virtual ceremony. My name is Michael Behe. I'm a professor of biochemistry at Lehigh University in Pennsylvania. And I'm the dad of one of this year's graduates, Gerard Behe. As a father of homeschooled children, I know the hard work that students such as yourselves invest in your own education during your high school years. I also know the sacrifices and efforts that parents of homeschoolers contribute in support of their children. For the past 4 years, you graduates have been developing the knowledge base and thinking skills that will enable you to take your place as valuable, active participants in our society. With the sustained effort that produces true satisfaction, you have learned the history of our country and other regions of the world, mastered the intricacies of the English language and some of its greatest literature. You have learned of many of the remarkable discoveries of science and know that our world is governed by understandable laws. In fact, you've learned that many of the phenomena of nature can be described in great detail by the mathematical systems that have been developed over the centuries, from the Arabic number system to the calculus. Together, these accomplishments make possible our modern technological society, a society into which you are now entering as full participants, a society which, because of its technological prowess, has a heightened capacity for both good and evil. Some of you graduates will continue your formal academic education in colleges and universities. Others may directly enter into the world of business and commerce, enlist in the military to serve our country, or embark on other paths. Yet all of you will continue to learn throughout your lives, not only from books and training programs, but also from your life experiences, which will be both joyful and sorrowful, bitter and sweet. One of the critical lessons you will learn over and over again is that humanity as a whole, although intelligent, is quite limited in its ability to understand the world. For many people in modern society, that lesson is difficult to believe. After all, our civilization has made truly impressive advances in areas such as science. We recently flew a helicopter on Mars. Government, we have the right to vote. And ethics, we try to treat all groups of people with dignity. Nonetheless, it turns out that there are hard, indefeasible limits on our ability to understand. Let me take a few minutes to explain why that must be true. In the late 17th century, Sir Isaac Newton published his great work, The Principia Mathematica. Let me share my screen with you here. In the book, he proposed his famous 3 laws of motion. For example, his first law states that an object in motion will remain in motion unless acted upon by a force. With just those three laws, Newton and the many students who later studied his work could predict everything from the trajectory of a cannonball to the movements of the moon and planets. To many educated people in the following centuries, the majestic sweep of Newton's laws seemed to imply that everything in heaven and earth simply had to be determined by those laws. Not only the actions of physical systems, but of living ones too. From rockets to the weather to the behavior of human societies. Those centuries were a time of increasing trust in human reason, where progress, such as that brought on by the Industrial Revolution, was thought to be inevitable. Over time, this led to a view that society should be governed by the smartest people, experts in academic fields of study. But it turned out that Newton's earlier work had barely scratched the surface of the world. When later scientists tried to dig deeper, they quickly ran into intractable problems. For example, Newton's laws of motion work wonderfully to predict, say, how a billiard ball will bounce off the cushions of a pool table. But what if the table also has obstacles on it, like those for bumper pool? Is there an equation to calculate where a billiard ball will end up after, say, 10 collisions with bumpers and cushions? No. There is no mathematical equation that will tell where the ball stops. Worse, mathematics concerns idealized situations where numbers can be designated exactly. But in the real world, there is always uncertainty in measuring the position or velocity of a billiard ball. That uncertainty rapidly compounds itself as the ball bounces off successive barriers. In a surprisingly short number of bounces, there is absolutely no way to know where the ball will end up. And that's the case with just one billiard ball. What if there were two balls bouncing around the billiard table, or three? Would more balls make it easier to predict a particular ball's position at any given time? Of course not. The more balls bouncing around, the very much more quickly the problem becomes intractable. Not only in practice, but even in theory. This hard conclusion of indeterminacy applies not only to billiard balls, but to all complex systems. For example, long-term weather forecasting. The same wonderful laws of physics that allow us to send a rocket to Mars are close to useless for accurately predicting whether, say, a thunderstorm will drop 0.7 inches of rain in Hellertown, Pennsylvania, on the 17th of August between 2:15 and 2:45 in the afternoon. Always remember this certain, this infallible lesson. Accurate long-term weather forecasting is impossible in principle. And the same goes for predicting the behavior of any complex system. Thus, if there is no way in principle to predict an event from deterministic laws, then there is no scientific reason to conclude that such events are completely determined by law. This most certainly includes complex biological systems. We have all had the unwanted opportunity to see that for ourselves this past year as the COVID-19 pandemic unfolded. Despite the enormous progress that science had made since the 1950s, when the structure of DNA was discovered, despite learning to clone genes, despite discovering the sophisticated molecular machinery of cells, scientists were largely at a loss to understand the behavior of that tiny virus, which has only 1/100,000th of the complexity of the human genome. Accurately predicting the detailed behavior of even a single tiny virus in nature is akin to long-term weather forecasting. It is impossible. What goes for ordinary physical systems goes in spades for ones that also involve intelligent agents. For example, consider the stock market. People organize stock markets to facilitate trade, but it is notoriously difficult to accurately predict which way the market will go tomorrow, let alone months from now. What's more, the market gives rise to unintended side effects that no one planned: booms, bubbles, crashes, busts, which can lead to immense consequences, such as the suicide of an investor who lost all of his money, or the impoverishment of millions of people. That same insuperable ignorance directly applies to politics and war. No one at the time knew that the gunshot in Sarajevo in 1914 that killed the Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria would lead to World War I, the deaths of 20 million people, and the destruction of the old world order. The intellectuals who promoted the French Revolution and communism thought that they were ushering in a more just world, not the reign of terror and the Holodomor. In an ill-considered tweet about 5 years ago, the astrophysicist and prolific media commentator Neil deGrasse Tyson wrote that he would like to see a new kind of virtual state set up that he dubbed Rationalia, which would have a one-sentence constitution: all policy shall be based on the weight of evidence. Tyson was roasted as hopelessly naive by the conservative writer Kevin Williamson. He pointed out that astrophysics, Tyson's own scientific specialty, tells us about the dense collapsed stars called black holes. Nothing can escape a black hole, including light. In a thought experiment, if a person were standing inside a black hole, he would be unable to see anything outside of it. The limit beyond which one can't see is called an event horizon. Anything beyond the event horizon would be unknowable. Similarly, wrote Williamson, here on Earth, all of us live within a boundary that sharply limits what we can know about the consequences of actions. Simply because of the complexity of the world, where even the future position of a billiard ball on a pool table can't be accurately predicted after just a few bounces, no one can know the future effects of actions that we take today. Williamson called that knowledge boundary an epistemic horizon. He wrote, quote, The limitations on human knowledge are real, and they are consequential. As men like him have done for ages, Tyson dreams of a world of self-evident choices, overseen by men of reason, who occupy a position that we cannot help but notice is godlike. It's nice to imagine ruling from an Olympus of reason, with men and nations arrayed before one as on a chessboard. Down here on Earth, the view is rather different, and the lines of sight inside the epistemic horizon are not nearly so long as our would-be rulers imagine. Instead of foolishly dreaming of a utopia that would be run by the world's smartest people, a much wiser approach was advocated 3,000 years ago by King David. In Psalm 119, he wrote, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path." David was praising God, excuse me, for allowing him to see just what was in front of him, where he was supposed to go just then, in that moment. David did not pray to know the far future or even the medium term. I think that is a wonderful and very practical attitude, not only for government leaders, but for each of us, especially new graduates such as yourselves who are beginning your adult lives. Throughout your lives, you should, of course, make plans for common anticipated events and needs, but don't be surprised if plans don't work out. Instead, be guided by your deepest principles at each step of your life's journey, applying them to unforeseen circumstances that have inexplicably arisen. Surprises will come along frequently, both pleasant ones and other ones too. When they do, don't let them knock you off the lighted path to grope and stumble in the darkness. Be grateful for the light given to you to take just the next step. So I conclude this commencement address by congratulating each one of you on all the hard work that has led you to this milestone in your lives. And I wish you not an orderly, comfortable life. Rather, I wish you the courage to persevere in following the light that guides your path. Congratulations.
Thank you. Greetings, Fall Class of 2021. You have been blessed with some of the best opportunities a high school student could ask for. You were taught by some of the best teachers, people who have already been on life's playing field, and who understand its possibility, potential, and struggles. People who are willing to teach you and to help you continue learning. You have been taught by some of the best teachers, mentors, and guides this world has to offer. The ones who have lived it. Our parents and guardians, teachers and mentors, authors and scientists, we have learned from them all. We have read their work, seen their words, studied their ideas through textbooks, documentaries, and the great multitude of books that line our walls. We have learned from our heroes, Austin, Tolkien, Einstein, and Newton. And always, we learn from our ultimate heroes, the ones who have raised us and taught us throughout the years, our people. These are the people who will continue to teach us, who will stand by our side, who will help us do our taxes for the first time. Yeah, most students aren't lucky enough to graduate high school with their favorite math and or science teacher, sports coach, and future accountant by their side, all rolled into a wonderful package we call Mom or Dad. I feel so blessed because I get to bring my best friends and my teachers into my future, even while I leave FA behind in a glorious array of multicolored falling graduation caps. I will forever be grateful for the 4 years I spent in its ranks with my fellow students and creative learners. For the past 4 years, I have been blessed to have learned, grown, and created around some of the best student minds of FA. Maybe some of the best student minds of all of Pennsylvania, or even all of the homeschooling world. Well, yeah, I am biased, but really, they're pretty amazing, and I couldn't have gotten to this place without their strength, enthusiasm, encouragement, and general zesty love of our shared homeschooling experience. My fellow FA students, you have been a joy to work with and beside. You have helped me grow and shaped who I've become. I can honestly say this community was the best opportunity FA gave me, but with my high school diploma from FA, I anticipate more opportunities, blessings, and wonderful experiences in my future, and I know I won't walk that path alone. I will go forth with my dearly beloved, strongly admired, and appreciated parents who have raised me and taught me for the past 18 years. I will continue to learn as homeschooling has taught me to. Because that is one of the beauties of homeschooling, isn't it? To be taught to learn, to gather knowledge wherever you go, and to grow as a person, daughter, friend, student, employee, and high school graduate of 2021. I want to thank everyone who has gotten me here. The board of directors of FA, the Richmonds, founders, leaders, and organizers of this wonderful program, which has gotten all of us to this place. All of the FA evaluators, my dearly beloved parents, grandparents, sister, and dear, dear friends, from many aspects of my life. And of course, you thought you could get away with from it, huh? The staff of the Excelsior, who have inspired me, driven me, taught me, and generally made me a better person. I would also like to thank the former editors of the Excelsior, whom I worked with and under in my earlier years of high school. I think there was somebody else I wanted to thank, but I don't remember who. Well, if you're out there listening, know that I appreciate all the love and support everyone who has touched my life has given me, and I fully look forward to taking the next steps in my life, and I hope that the people aforementioned, those who desire to and wish to, will join me in that journey. Now, FA Class of 2021, since I've taken most of this time thanking people and making minor not very amusing jokes, I'm going to pass this on to you. Arguably the most well-educated, most on the trajectory to their chosen forms of success, and maybe even the most good-looking class of 2021. Well, maybe not. You've spent the past 4 years earning this moment, this piece of paper, and the past 12 years to get to this place. You are as prepared for the next phase of your life as you will be, and I cannot wait to see what you make of that. I wish the best to all of you, class of 2021, and I anticipate your arrival at whatever form of success you choose. I mean, after all, we are homeschoolers, of PHAA no less. We're set, or as much so as any 18-year-old struggling to do their taxes for the first time can be. So here's to us, FOSS students. True to who we are, anchored in the past 4 years of learning from people who meant the most to us. On behalf of my fellow students, thank you all. Best wishes to class of 2021. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Ava Moss, and I'm going to read a poem I wrote this year. The future seems so bright, like a star shining in the night. I miss the warmth that was the past, the warmth I knew would never last. Each step I take into this new cold, I feel myself becoming less bold. Within the world I once resided, I didn't need to be reminded. I knew my way around, I found what was to be found. In this new dawn that breaks, the lack of familiarity aches. Shielding my eyes against the sun, I begin to think this could be fun. Whilst I know not what to expect, I know my strength will not neglect. Stepping forward with careful feet, it's the beginning of something sweet. With fear in tow, I step into what I do not know. But I know one thing, the echoes of comfort will once again ring.
Hello, and congratulations to the Pennsylvania homeschoolers graduating class of 2021. Following a year and a half of worldwide shutdowns due to COVID-19, many have been forced to reconsider their approach to education and were left with no choice but to learn from home. Naturally, as many assumed, the group most unaffected would be those who were previously homeschooling. After all, as the name suggests, homeschooling takes place at home. And while it is true that every room in my house has doubled as a classroom at some point in time, people very rarely realize the role that outside experiences play in a homeschooler's education. Homeschooling is not about recreating public school experiences, but rather about the creation of an entirely new experience. Not only does this make the student an active agent in their education, but it challenges them to seek out innovative ways of reaching their goals. And so much of that innovation takes place outside of the home. As a visual and performing artist, homeschooling never hindered me from experiencing the arts. It opened the door to greater possibilities by allowing me to structure a curriculum around them. I often tell people that I was partially homeschooled and partially went to a performing arts school because I did. I've partaken in acting, dance, and vocal performance and stage right in Greensburg, all while keeping hold of my educational experience. So when the inevitable happened and shutdowns took the world by storm, what did I do? Well, I transferred to Zoom. I strapped on a mask. I sang, danced, and acted in the hot summer sun, 6 feet apart. I interpreted the world around me through art. I painted everything I felt and saw, and I found beauty where there seemed to be none. And why? Because I'm an artist. And I'm a homeschooler. And the thing that those two groups have in common is our ability to think outside the box. It's that need to seek out new solutions that's been so instilled in me and led me to my future career as an art therapist. I want to grant to others the ability to take control of their mental health through art, just as I have been allowed to take control of so many of my pursuits. The freedom of expression and its therapeutic nature is one that I eagerly await to give to others, and that is thanks to the unique approach of my homeschool education. By meeting every situation with an airy freshness and an open mind, I've been able to explore all that the world and the arts have to offer. So thank you to my family, to Mr. and Mrs. Richmond, and to all my educators and mentors for reaching me exactly where I and every other student we come into contact with needs to be met, for pushing us outside of our comfort zones, and for challenging us to think critically, creatively, and individualistically, so that we may pass on the same love and ingenuity to others. Once again, congratulations, class of 2021. Here's to the brightest future ahead.
Thank you. to be of service. We sway back and forth. Another bead slips through my hands. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. I stand surrounded by Hungarians in a crowded tram. I stare out into the dark glass. 11, midnight. It's late. I glance toward my four younger siblings, huddled on borrowed seats next to my father. He is standing firm, gripping a beam. His soft, bearded face is solemn, masking concern and worry. My mother should be with us. Here we are in Budapest, foreigners on my father's Fulbright. I was 16 years old, the eldest for the first time in my life after my sister left for college. Before we arrived here, all eight of us were packed into two small cars traveling Europe, camping and staying in friends' spare rooms to save money. The Bovington Tank Museum satiated my passion for World War II history. I enjoyed conversing in French with a street painter near Notre Dame and sketching Parisian architecture for myself. We hiked the steeples of the Swiss Alps and wandered the cathedrals of Italy, finding the beauty of God and creation, learning with every step, our family bonds deepening. Back on the tram, an elderly woman silently smiles at me, tilting her head as if to ask, "What are you seeking? Where are you going?" I muster a smile. "I don't know." The door opens and I am shoved, stumbling out, my pack filled with my laptop and my AP European History textbook. A hand reaches out, my own, to the woman in the tram, helping her down the tram steps. "Kusinem," she thanks me. "Yo este," I reply, "Yo este," and hoist my little brother upon my shoulders. We head for home, worried that something will knock my mother's leg, releasing blood clots upon her heart. The door shuts behind us. Another bead. A shuffle. Dad is up to visit Mom in the hospital and then to teach. The door closes. I open my laptop to the AP language class website to do my morning assignments, planning to continue a passionate discussion of Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice. But the website is broken. The SHTML pages are not loading correctly. The sidebar and every name is gone, replaced by a simple message. An error occurred while processing this directive. Reboot? Still an error. AP Computer Science, where I'm a TA, error there too. Macroeconomics, the My Messages subdirectory, my.pl, loads without errors. Using that functional sidebar, I test each subdirectory. A pattern arises. The JavaScript is bugging, but the Perl directories are working. With those directories, most of the site is still usable. I smile, leaning back in my chair. I can fix this. I can help. I email my findings to the site admin and post bypass links to help other students navigate the site. The next day, I learned that my teacher had recommended me for my problem solving and programming to the site admin, and there was a coding internship in my inbox. A shout rings through the silent apartment. "Me need help," declares the three-year-old. Different work calls. My younger siblings and I are pirates as we bury treasure in the sandboxes in Budapest's parks. We become valiant knights in our rafter apartment. Sometimes I take the youngest walking, putting him to sleep on my shoulders. Another bead. I am practicing with the English-speaking choir in Budapest's Basilica. The other members hail from around the world, yet welcome me as a member of their family. I am working on the piano accompaniment to a Nigerian hymn. What shall I offer to the Lord to make him happy? A humble heart, a loving heart. Here is what I seek, a humble, loving heart, a servant's heart, to help others, learning with each step. Another bead. My little brother and I stand with our noses pressed against the bright glass, watching planes depart. We will be departing soon, flying home with my mother. All is well. Thank you. Thank you.
Grace Barnett. Grace Elizabeth Barnett is from Canonsburg, Pennsylvania, and was always homeschooled. She earned English and math honors and was on the Excelsior staff her junior year. Grace plays several instruments, including piano, ukulele, clarinet, and xylophone. She studies karate, enjoys traveling, and currently works at Zoop. She has been a teacher and volunteer with children's Bible camps and has helped at the local senior center, and has served in numerous capacities at Grace Baptist Church for many years. She will attend Butler Community College, Cranberry, in the fall to study photography.
It's been a tradition in the Barnett family that on the first day of school, ever since kindergarten, Dad would always walk Grace and her brother in for the first day. So we thought that we would end her journey the same way that we began. Grace, on behalf of Barnett Family Schools, I present to you a diploma that represents all your hard work and excellence over these last 13 years. It's been my privilege and honor to be your teacher and your mom. I love you.
I love you. Thank you.
Grace, it has been my privilege not only is to be your father, but also your principal. Congratulations to you on all your hard work and your success. And we pray for you daily, and we'll be praying that as you go into college, that you will continue to take that drive and determination with you into your college years. Remember, Joshua 1:9 says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not fear. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." And God will be with you. He knows the plans and the purpose that he has for you. And he will be with you, and just pray you continue to seek him throughout your days. We love you. And congratulations.
Thank you. You may turn your tassel.
Gerard Behe. Gerard has always been homeschooled, and he wouldn't have had it any other way. Born and raised in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, the youngest of 9 homeschooled Behe kids, Gerard is an honor student who enjoys competitive chess, Catholic apologetics, and theater. In the fall, he will attend Thomas Aquinas College to study theology and philosophy. Gerard thanks his parents and siblings for their unfailing support and his friends for making him laugh. Above all, he thanks God for having brought him to this day.
Gerard, in honor of 12 years worth of hard work and outstanding scholarship, we award you with great pride this diploma.
Congratulations, dear. You can now switch your tassel from the right to the left. Congratulations.
Hannah Blackman. Hannah Blackman lives in Red Hill, Pennsylvania with her mom, dad, and 5 siblings. She's been homeschooled her whole life. She's enjoyed learning piano for the past 8 years. She's also self-taught in the guitar. She also loves to crochet. Her favorite movie is Remember the Titans, and her favorite song is It's Still the Cross by Andy Gleiser. Aaron Dietzel. Aaron Edward Dietzel began his homeschooling education in the spring semester of the 8th grade and has completed his high school years, receiving a diploma with an emphasis in music, in which he is passionate and gifted. For now, he plans to work as an intern at our local church while taking a gap year and making a decision to attend college. We are so proud of the man he is becoming, his character, and the joy that he brings wherever he goes. Aaron is a man after God's own heart, and his gifts will make room for him in the world. May he continue to grow in the love and knowledge of the Lord and walk in his purpose to bring others to know truth and freedom. Mom, Dad, and Emily are so proud of you, as well as our extended family. We love you, Aaron.
Aaron Edward Dietzel.
Walk up.
Yeah.
Thank you for everybody for coming for the graduation of 2021 of
Freedom Academy
School. And we have one special person. We have 2 special people, actually. We have a graduating son, and we have the Teacher of the Year.
Aww.
The teacher of the last 4 years. Yeah. She won it 4 years in a row. And we're so proud. And we are so proud of Aaron. Let me just introduce Aaron. So the next graduate is Aaron Edward Ditzel.
All right.
Thank you, Mom, for the past 3 years, 4 years.
Outstanding.
All right. All
right. Hannah Duckett. Hannah Duckett has been homeschooled kindergarten through 12th grade, along with attending the Stage Wright School for Performing Arts in Greensburg, Pennsylvania, throughout her high school. In addition to performing, she's dedicated herself to the visual arts and is graduating with honors in studio art, art history, drama, and English. She will be majoring in art therapy and minoring in theater at Mercyhurst University this fall.
Hannah, we award you this diploma for your achievement and your high honors in English, studio art, drama, and art history. Congratulations. You may now move your tassel.
Kira Frankman. Kira Frankman lives in Chester County with her family and animals. She grew up homeschooling, working on local farms, volunteering at libraries, and an assisted living facility. Kira's passions lie in photography, agriculture, and literature. Although uncertain what her future holds, she hopes to pursue interests in the working entrepreneurial world. Luke Hoffman. Luke is curious and hardworking. He surprised his mother by learning to read at age 4. Has become skilled at playing the guitar, banjo, and mandolin. He's also learned to write code and to use audio software to compose music. He will attend DeSales University, majoring in computer science.
Congratulations.
Janae Horn. Janae Tabitha Horn is the daughter of James and Rhonda Horn, and she grew up in East Mount Airy, Philadelphia. Her mother homeschooled her for 12 years, 11 of which took place in the home she grew up. She is the seventh of 8 siblings, 5 sisters and 3 brothers, 5 of whom graduated from the Pennsylvania Homeschoolers Accreditation Agency. Janae's interests include singing, cooking, and baking. She also enjoys animals, playing the violin, doing hair, and watching a good basketball or football game. Janae has studied the violin since the age of 6 and is an aspiring solo violinist. She has performed in many places. The Kimmel Center and the Met in Philadelphia have been her most memorable. Janae is taking a gap year to focus on her music, but she plans to attend college and major in music performance in September 2022. Janae also plans on becoming a veterinarian assistant.
Janae, it's been a wonderful blessing watching you grow up and develop your own convictions and beliefs. I'm remembering all those late nights of homeschooling when you were so determined to stay up late and get your work done, even sometime before it was due. I have no doubt that with all the skills, talents, and abilities God has gifted you with, that you would continue to be a great success.
Janae, it's a privilege to be your father. You're a wonderful daughter, and we thank God for bringing you this far, for the gifts and the talents and abilities that He's given you, and for your stewardship as a student. And we are here to say we love you, and we're here to encourage you, and we know that you'll be successful in whatever you do. God bless you.
It is a great pleasure that we present to you this day your high school diploma from Pennsylvania Homeschoolers. Congratulations. Good luck.
Eli Mazenheimer. Eli is from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and has been homeschooled his entire life. He's planning on studying industrial design at Cedarville University in Ohio. He loves to design and invent products, act at his local theater, play soccer for his club team, go fishing on the weekends, play piano and electric guitar, and cook and bake. He's also an avid bird watcher, attracting 40 of the 45 species of birds that come to feeders in Pennsylvania. He would like to thank his family and friends for their continuous support throughout his homeschool journey.
Eli, it is truly an honor and a privilege to be your mom and a joy to have been your teacher. Watching you grow and learn and mature into the amazing young man that you are has been an incredible blessing. You have so many gifts and talents and varied interests, and it has been fun learning all about them alongside you. You have made life very interesting. We pray you always stay curious and immerse yourself in the things that bring you joy. We are so excited for your future and all that God has for you. We love you. And we present you your diploma. You are now a graduate of the class of 2021.
Matthew Mazzetti. Matthew Ryan Mazzetti is from Macungie, Pennsylvania, and has been homeschooling for 7 years. He's graduating with 34 college credits earned as a dual enrollment student at Lehigh Carbon Community College. For the past 4 years, Matthew has been an active member of his Boy Scout troop, where he's enjoyed many camping trips, completing merit badge work, and participating in many community service projects. He's also volunteered at Awana, VBS, Miracle League of the Lehigh Valley, and Operation Christmas Child. In his free time, Matthew enjoys hanging out with his twin sister Sarah and younger sister Elizabeth and playing with his dog Cosmo. He also loves reading, writing, and playing video games. Matthew will be attending the Honors College at George Mason University, where he plans to major in statistics or actuarial science.
In addition of your hard work as a homeschooler, we award you this diploma.
Congratulations, Matthew. You may now leave your tassel.
Michael McGeary. Michael Jochen McGeary of New Kensington is thankful to receive his Pennsylvania Homeschoolers Accreditation Agency High School Diploma as the fifth and final sibling of the McGeary Homeschool student body. Through the years, Michael has had many wonderful learning opportunities, such as improving language skills at Duquesne University's speech clinic, participating as a member of Kiske Valley Presbyterian Church and Youth Group, creating art with Creative Citizen Studios and selling some of his work, studying piano with Melody's Piano Studio, volunteering at Tri-Life Center Family Resource Center, coaching volleyball with Dad at Penn State New Kensington, and traveling, including many family visits that have taken them to Beaver Falls and York, Pennsylvania, the Black Hills of South Dakota, Granger, Indiana, Austin, Texas, the Washington, D.C. area, and the beaches of New Jersey and North Carolina. He will continue volunteering and gaining valuable skills for future work with a desire to help doctors.
Michael Jochen McGeary, we're here for your graduation.
Yeah.
And we are so proud of you. And congratulations as well to every graduate from 2021. Michael, we're so very proud of you, and your family is here with you, and they are very proud of you as well.
Yeah.
Right. Now I'll give you your diploma.
Okay.
It says you are a high school graduate. You did hard work.
Yeah.
And your mom is going to move your tassels.
Yeah, you can pin it, right? Here, Michael, this tassel goes over here. Thank you so much for being a wonderful student.
Yeah.
This is your Pennsylvania Homeschooler's Diploma.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. I'll hold this.
And your siblings would like to say congratulations. Look into their...
Congratulations!
Great work, Michael. We're proud of you for all of your perseverance and diligence in all of your learning, and especially your piano.
We're very proud of you.
Great work, Bubba.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Michael.
Great work. So proud of you. Love you.
Good.
Congratulations on all your hard work. You've done such a great job.
Yeah. Good.
Thank you.
All right. Siblings here, Michael.
Give him a hug. Good. I'll give him a hug.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Michael. You're the hardest worker I know and one of my best friends.
Yeah.
I love you.
Good work. And one parting gesture. We're going to sing to you, Michael, right?
Yeah.
Happy graduation to you.
Woo!
Happy graduation to you.
Woo!
Happy graduation, dear Michael.
Happy graduation to you.
This is your graduation song.
Ava Moss. Ava Moss lives in Cranberry Township with her father, mother, and two sisters, Zara and Bianca. She's very artistic and loves glassworking, fashion, writing poetry, and playing the piano. She has a true heart for those with special needs and has spent many hours volunteering in various church ministries. In her senior year, she attended Butler County Community College and worked over 20 hours per week at a cashier at the Giant Eagle grocery store. After graduation, she will join the Honors College at Kent State University, where she will major in interior design. David Richman. David Richman was born in Kittenning, Pennsylvania, and homeschooled all his life. He currently lives in Norfolk, Virginia, with his parents and six siblings, but will return to Pennsylvania to attend St. Vincent College in Latrobe, where he intends to major in computer science and education. David loves playing piano, drawing, singing, dancing, programming, and backpacking. Some highlights of David's high school education were traveling to six European countries, running the Discord server for his AP computer science class, and being one of the top 10 finalists in the American Foreign Service Agency's essay contest with his essay, Cultural Warfare, U.S. Soft Power in Hungary. When David is not writing an essay, playing with a small gaggle of young children, or composing at the piano, you will most likely see him riding his bike or longboard to church to volunteer or canter. Megan Stremmel. Megan Stremmel was born on May 18, 2004 in Baltimore, Maryland, as the fourth of five children. Her family moved to Pennsylvania when she was 1 year old. She's been homeschooled her whole life, playing soccer with Upper Adams AYSO since she was four, and playing soccer and running track with the Biglerville Middle and High Schools. She is also a leader in her youth group at Celebration Community Church. Megan is graduating a year early and has earned 33 college credits from Harrisburg Area Community College while carrying a 4.0 GPA throughout her entire high school career. In the fall, she will be attending Johnson & Wales University in Providence, Rhode Island, as a major in culinary arts. She would like to thank her parents, siblings, nephew Micah, family, teachers, and friends for all their love and support.
Yay!
Stephen Treadle. Stephen Treadle lives in Pittsburgh and has been homeschooled for 12 years. He's very active in his church, having participated as youth leader and teacher in summer Bible camps. Currently, he coordinates and teaches a bi-monthly teen Bible study. Stephen was very active in the Boy Scouts, developing a love for hiking, camping, and mentoring younger scouts, and even achieved the rank of Eagle Scout. In his spare time, Stephen enjoys writing stories, reading, and playing piano. He enjoys working construction and is pursuing training in woodworking with the Carpenters Union Apprenticeship Program this fall in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Dad and Mom thank God for the opportunity and privilege to have homeschooled Stephen and are proud of his outstanding accomplishments.
Stephen, in recognition of your hard work these past 12 years in our homeschool, we would like to award you your high school diploma.
We're very proud of the man that you've become and all the accomplishments that you've achieved. Now it's time to graduate. Please move your tassel from the right to the left.
Nathan Zufall. Nathan grew up in Bolivar and has been homeschooled since the second grade, enjoying a biblically based education. He's been active in 4-H for 10 years, doing various projects, and was the secretary of the club for 2 years. He enjoys archery, hunting, playing stringed instruments, foraging, gardening, and oil painting. He's also been very active in church activities and serving. Nathan looks forward to starting school at Johnstown Career and Technology Center in the Mobile Equipment Operations Program to become a heavy equipment operator, and he's excited to see what other things God has in store for the future.
Nathan Charles Zupal, it pleases me to see the young man you've become, and I'm honored and privileged to present you with a diploma for a job well done, son.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. You've done a wonderful job. It's been an amazing homeschool journey. I look forward to the future to see what God has in store for you. Just remember to always trust in the Lord with all your heart and soul and mind. Congratulations. I love you.
You too. Love you, son.
Now, by the authority of Section 1327.1 of the School Code, which in 1988 made Pennsylvania the first state to enact high school graduation requirements for homeschoolers. And by the authority of the regulations of the State Board of Education, the first regulations in the country to recognize homeschooling accreditation agencies. And by the authority of the Pennsylvania Department of Education, which fully recognizes the diplomas awarded by our agency, and by the authority of the Board of Directors of Pennsylvania Homeschoolers Accreditation Agency, I now pronounce these students to be high school graduates of home education programs. Congratulations to all of our graduates. Normally after a graduation ceremony, the graduates proceed out and we congratulate them in the lobby. If you are watching this ceremony during its premiere on Monday, June 7th, you can congratulate them on Zoom in our virtual lobby. The link is below.